Well, good Wednesday morning, everyone. Great to see you here on Inspiration for Today. And oh, Virginia is already waving to you. Hi, Virginia.
Good morning. Good day.
Before we get into our talk, though, let me just say that in about an hour and a half at the United Methodist Church is the food pantry, to this month's food pantry. And if you or one of your neighbors could use some encouragement in the food area this month, please go by. It's from 9 to 10:30. So that's just a little bit later this morning. We're in the process of learning about various ministries at Saddleback Laguna Woods. Virginia leads in two. One is hospitality and the other is?
Needle Gals.
Needle Gals. Love the name. Love the name. But we'll hear about it here in a moment. What's your verse for today?
My verse today is Ephesians 2:10. We are God's handiwork created in Christ Jesus to do God's works, which God prepared us in advance to do. So that's a promise. And
a challenge. So, yeah.
Yes, exactly. And we have various gifts and they change throughout our lifetime. So
it's a great way. By the way, did you know that in the original Greek, it says that to do the coffee and helps ministry at Saddleback that God has prepared you to do?
Yes.
Did you know there that? Is... That's the original Greek.
They're so clever. They're so smart.
All right. No, folks, Virginia read it correctly. But tell us about the ministry of hospitality. Because that does include kind of a lot of things. It could be different things, right?
Yes. Well, we arrive at church and start setting up all the accoutrements that are needed for the various food items that we present. Along
so this
with
is everything that people enjoy, like when you come in the foyer. Your ministry has to do with everything from the eggs to the donuts to whatever, right?
Exactly. So we have the eggs, the donuts, the coffee or hot tea, and then your creamers and all those kinds of things that people like to put into their coffee. And we have flavored creamers too, and some veggies and dip. And so I'm telling you, there's nothing better than a Saddleback Church hot blessed cup of coffee. You have to come back each week for it. It's so good.
And didn't you say because it's blessed, it tastes better?
Absolutely, guaranteed.
Yeah,
that's
a
promise. Yes.
Well, you know what I actually also enjoy there, Virginia, that you didn't actually mention, but it's actually the smiles and greetings.
Yes.
From your folks. And it's a point of contact with almost everyone who comes to church, comes by and meets with you and your team. So,
and that's the wonderful thing about hospitality. We are able to just about meet everybody because everybody needs a little something, something Sunday morning that we offer. And so it's a wonderful opportunity to greet and meet our church family members.
Yes,
and it's such a reward.
And you guys do such a great job. But I just, you know, we're always have the open opportunity for more to help. And I know that specifically, well, it doesn't, if you could come and talk with Virginia, that would be great. I know we're doing these shows in preparation for the ministry fair. But Virginia is one who's there every week and you can talk to her. You don't have to wait for that.
Yeah, exactly.
And you can use, some could help set up, but also I know that kind of the clean, there's an opportunity for cleanup helpers.
Yes.
Especially after or during the start of second service.
Correct. Yeah. And you could, let's say you only have 20 minutes after the service to help with cleanup. We appreciate those 20 minutes. Yeah. And, you know, just stay as long as you can. Every helping hand is greatly appreciated.
But that particular role is from, basically it's from 11 to 11:20 or 11:30.
Exactly.
Because you have to serve second service first.
Yeah. So once second service starts, then we start putting everything away and freshening up those coffee pots for the next Sunday.
So folks, if you are actually, if you enjoy that breakfast, I would encourage you to help for a season.
Yes.
You know, it doesn't have to be forever. It could be for the until you go away in June to to Montana. Because a lot of folks are here for a few months and maybe you just serve while you're here. That anything that you can do, we would appreciate. Now, before we run out of time, Needle Gals.
Yes, Needle Gals, we started this group in 2015. And basically, we make various different items for assisted living. And since the beginning of this time to where we are today, we have really expanded the different items and the connections that we make with various different assisted living, but within our Laguna Woods community also with the help of Meals on Wheels and social services. So you work at your own pace, but what we really, really need is those that are gifted with the ability to sew. We make for memory care, adult bibs, and we make aprons, we make simple items. You might have something that you could add to the mix that would be wonderful, but we really need those that can sew. But if you crochet or knit, we'd love to have you join this group. It's extremely rewarding.
I gotta throw in a couple of things, Virginia. One, I wish we had time for the amazing stories of how thankful people are when they get these gifts. It's just amazing. And secondly, I wanted to say, because we just had Joan on a couple of days ago, and she made the point that a lot of the assisted living aren't doing the worship services right now. But don't let that stop you from what Virginia is saying, because the gifts that you would make still go in. They accept those and they love those.
Yes. And they celebrate birthdays with our gifts too. But most importantly, we want people to know that they're not forgotten, that God loves them. And so this is a way that they can feel God's love and know that our church is praying for them.
And the other thing with Needle Gals is I think you get together and actually knit and crochet or sew or whatever you do. Don't you do that together sometimes?
Absolutely. Once a month, we get together and we encourage and support one another, share ideas and patterns. And we accept all yarn donations, fabric donations, and gift cards from yarn shops so that we can keep going, you know?
Yes. Now, does any talking amongst yourselves take place during those meetings?
Well, yeah. Quite a bit of chatter, that's for sure. And we do have such fun sharing our gifts with one another. It's a real blessing. I just can't share it enough.
See, that's what I've heard over time. Well, actually, I've come to one or two. To enjoy the sociability of it. I do love the ministry and I wanted you to tell us about it today. So folks, if you are interested, and I pray that you are, in either helping in hospitality, well, actually you could do both because Needle Gals is completely separate from Sundays, but Needle Gals or hospitality, then you have the information below on how you can contact Virginia. Or you can talk to her on Sunday, even about either one. Yeah. So until tomorrow when we meet another great minister, God bless. Have a great day. Bye.
Love you. Bye-bye.